But then again, I mean, the original, how can you top it all?
Yeah, and...
And, you know, with the whole CGI, it just would make it kind of crap.
Well, they're supposed to be CGI in Chucky.
That's retarded. They can use a doll.
Yeah, it worked in the first one.
It did. It worked in all of them.
But, you know, my gripe about if they do a remake of Leprechaun is there are very few things that bring me back to the early 90s or the 90s in general, such as, like, Game Boys, Pogs, Super Nintendo, all that good stuff. And Leprechaun is one of those movies that pulls me back to the 90s. And, I mean, you have those horrible Nash Bridges cell phones in it.
And then you have the high tops. And then the socks that go over the high tops. And then the funky looking shorts.
What was the deal with Jennifer Aniston's shorts anyway?
I really don't know. It looked like she took a pair of blue jean shorts. Or they probably were pants, and she cut them off into shorts, and then got some kind of funky looking material and sewed it on her pockets and the bottom of them. It just looked really weird. She did wear a nice tank top that most of us girls wear today, but other than that, her whole apparel was just, yeah. How did we ever get away with that back in the 90s?
You know, you should really rock that look again. I bet if we went out to the bar and you rocked that look, you would at least have someone come up and, you know, offer to buy you a few drinks. Maybe not even out of if you're beautiful in it, but due to the fact where they're like, oh God, look at what that poor girl's wearing. Let me buy her a drink. She definitely needs one.
I think I would make it look a lot better than Jennifer Aniston.
Oh, you hear that? There's a match.
Well, I do have more traits than she will ever have.
You know, if Jennifer Aniston ever listens to this, you know, and she decides we're going to match up and see who can wear it best, would you wear that outfit compared next to Jennifer Aniston?
I would, and I would go without makeup or any other enhancements for my body.
Yes, indeed. All right, and pretty much what we would like to discuss next is going to be, if they did do the remake, who would you see playing the roles best?
Probably the guy that played Mini-Me. He could probably do it. He is small enough. Or maybe one of the other little people from the most recent Snow White movie they did.
I don't know. Warwick Davis is just awesome.
Those are some pretty big shoes to fill, though. He is an amazing actor.
He really is. I believe the first movie that I ever remember seeing Warwick Davis in was, I want to say Willow.
Me too. I am a huge fan of Willow. It's one of my favorite movies of all time.
Let's see. He was not only in Willow, but besides the Leprechaun movies, of course, he had ended up showing up in Star Wars Episode 1.
Yes, he did.
He was also in The Tenth Kingdom, which was a TV miniseries. And he played in a few of the Harry Potter movies.
Yes, he is Professor Flitwick. I'm a Harry Potter fan, too.
Potter rocks.
He sure does.
To even go off into left field here, he was even in the movie Ray, the Ray Charles movie that had Jamie Foxx in it. So, I mean, I think that Warwick Davis is a very underrated actor. He's a very versatile actor.
That he is.
And I just can't see anyone else filling those shoes besides Warwick Davis. So I'll have to say, if they do a remake, they need to keep Warwick Davis if they want it to be good.
I don't think anybody else can actually do the voice either. He just has a very unique voice, and he's just an awesome person.
Now, as far as Jennifer Aniston is concerned, maybe... the girl that played in Mamma Mia, what's her name?
Amanda Seyfried?
Yeah, her. I think she might would do good.
Yes. And I don't really think she has to change her hair either.
No.
It doesn't really matter.
Yeah, and besides, she did good in Jennifer's Body as, like, being the victim for most of the movie, and then turning around and being the kick-ass superhero of it, you know?
She was pretty awesome. She's very versatile, too. And underrated.
Oh, yes. And as far as the three guys that paint, I guess the little boy, he could just be some random little boy.
He could be. I mean, those really weren't too big of parts, and I think almost anybody can play them.
Now, the guy that played as Ozzy, just a sick, sad part of me, really wants to see Jack Black get hacked up with, like, the shoe buckle.
That would be awesome to see.
Yeah, so.
I mean, I think Jack Black could do it. He can play a mentally challenged person.
Yeah, it wouldn't be too much of a stretch.
Yes, it wouldn't be. It wouldn't be at all.
And as far as the attractive guy goes, that Jennifer Aniston was all over, the one that played as Nathan.
He was pretty.
Who would you say?
I don't know, really. There are too many very gorgeous actors out there that could play that part. He would have to be muscular, of course, because that guy did have some pretty big guns.
You're lusting.
Well, I am a female in her prime.
And so, single.
Yes, I am single.
So, any guys out there who have big, muscly arms and is looking for a nice little British girl?
He has to be tall, too.
And go for it.
All right.
Yeah, she'll probably add you on her Facebook if you just send her a friend request saying, I have big, muscly arms.
As long as there's a picture involved.
And also, if you look like Warwick Davis, I think that's like a triple. But if you have teeth like the leprechaun, but you don't look like him.
Ooh, that is 100% I love.
Wait, you like his rotted teeth?
It's an appeal.
Well, you could have dated half of the people in the South then.
No, I just don't like them. They're too cranky.
Oh, not all of them are.
That and they are on crystal meth, and we just don't do drugs.
No, that's only in a few areas, though.
No, most of the areas I've come in contact with.
Oh, well, you're just in the wrong areas, then.
I guess so. I need to get out of Mississippi.
I like Mississippi. It's fun.
It's not my place.
And besides, we have that great St. Paddy's Day parade over in Jackson that the Sweet Potato Queens are at. Have you ever seen them before?
No, I haven't. I've always wanted to, but I'm always not around when that comes.
Oh, it's awesome. The St. Paddy's Day parade in Jackson, Mississippi is amongst the top 5 biggest St. Paddy Day parades in America.
I have heard that.
And the Sweet Potato Queens are just awesome. You have, like, this group of little ladies running out with these big Peg Bundy wigs and, you know, glamorous green dresses and all that good stuff. And
that would be fun to participate in.
And for the people who cannot see this, the reason why Minnie Fierce is being quiet for the majority of the time is because she's scoffing down a bucket full of corned beef and cabbage, and she's trying her hardest not to burp as she's guzzling.
I'm trying to be a lady. As my mother did try to raise me right.
As she's also guzzling her Guinness. I guess Irish people do hold their alcohol well.
I do have quite the tolerance.
And back to talking about who could fill the shoes of the actors and actresses in the movie. Okay, so we haven't decided on a person for Nathan.
No, we need to come back to that later while I have my thoughts.
Yeah, what's that one guy's name?
Which one?
That Goobler dude.
Matthew Gray Goobler.
Yeah, he could.
He could play the part, but he would really have to beef up.
Yeah, you know, just for it.
I do know of a really handsome actor. He's underrated as well, but he is just gorgeous. He's from Australia. His name is Chris Hemsworth. He is in the new Thor movie. Absolutely gorgeous. Big, muscly arms. Mm.
Okay, well, since I am unfamiliar with him, we'll just go with that name for that dude and keep on going.
Okay, you can look him up later.
All right, Dan O'Grady, the old guy.
The old guy. That's not really a stretch too far. You can get some random Irish actor or British actor or just, I don't know, somebody who does have an Irish background.
I don't know. It would almost kind of be fun to see Ben Stiller's dad. Jerry Stiller.
Or Ben Stiller himself. He's getting quite old.
Yeah, but, you know, he doesn't have that. I'm not trying to say anything bad about Jerry Stiller, but he doesn't have that, you know, really uptight, sloppy look when it comes down to the roles. Because, I mean, he has that role down pretty good on the King of Queens, and there's been a few movies, but I'm a big Jerry Stiller fan and a big Ben Stiller fan. I love their work.
I'm not really too fond of Ben Stiller.
I like him. He's done some pretty good stuff. I'd like I'd like to see him in a serious role, though.
Yes, me too, because he does way too many comedies, and I think that everybody needs to have a diverse
and
background.
Just for shits and giggles. for Miss O'Grady.
The woman who broke her neck.
Paula Deen.
No, she's a little too big.
But you know, when she serves the tea, she could also, like, put some hors d'oeuvres with it as well.
She could.
Yeah.
But Paula Deen is a true southerner, and you can really tell that. So she would have to really, really get down with the accent.
Kathy Bates. But the only problem is... Awesome. The only problem with Kathy Bates is if she could get her hands on a sledgehammer...
The leprechaun would no longer exist.
No, he wouldn't. She would chase him around with a sledgehammer, saying, well, I'm not your number one fan, but hey, whatever works.
Yes, I do like those nice shiny buckles you have on your shoes.
Where's your gold? I love you.
I will love you forever. Just give me your gold.
Well, I think we've touched, like, the most important characters of the movie.
Yes.
And hopefully, if they did do a remake, it would have a little bit of a better soundtrack than the original. Because even though the musical score was good, you keep hearing that one country sounding song, yes. Four Leaf Clover, come up every 5 to 10 minutes. And I'm so grateful that they did not play that song again during the end credits.
Oh, yes. I'll drink to that.
But, you know, since it would be Irish-based, maybe they could get something in there like the Cranberries or Flogging Molly, you know? That would be really awesome.
That would be nice to have an actual Irish band.
And, talking of which, I wonder if they would keep the quotes. Especially my personal favorite, pardon the phrase, fuck you, Lucky Charms.
That was my favorite, too. That and the one she said about being in the 90s.
Yeah, but if they remade it, you know, they wouldn't put it in the 90s.
Welcome to the new millennium.
Yeah, but, you know, is it still technically new, considering that we're now in the second decade of the millennium?
No.
Yeah, because, I mean, they would take that out completely.
Yeah, that would be kind of a bust.